proposals were submitted to bring the concept to reality. The concept was first flown in the mid-1970s as the B. Fighter, like we're going to be flying the Tornado out here in a few minutes. The nose of the air, the side of the nose of the airplane, they are angled down, but that's what helps to eliminate the get yourselves over to the black flag located between the runway and the taxiway. That's St. John's Ambulance Tent. That's the medical center, and that's also the Found People Center. So, parents, get yourselves over there if you're missing your kids or if you need some place to meet your friends. The black flag you see flying atop that post is at the St. John's Ambulance Tent. And that's where to go. That's the. That's also. I think they're also functioning as the lost and found, as a man get it back together with its owner. There is our B-1 bomber. Our B-1 bomber flown by the pilots today: Captain Cameron Humphreys from Sheridan, Wyoming; Captain Phil Weilhauer from East Windsor, Connecticut; the offensive systems officer, Captain John Erickson,
can tail off in 2,500 feet. With automatic terrain following, this bomber can fly at speeds in excess of 700 miles an hour at 200 feet above the ground in day or night in any kind of weather. It's 146 feet long, 34 feet high, with a span of 137 feet, wings forward, or 78 feet fully swept. Let's watch as our B-1B from Dyess Air Force Base in Texas begins its takeoff roll. Configured, and they're going to have the plane slow down. I don't see rollers hanging out just yet, so this is a in the lower speed regime as he makes a pass overhead. Helps with the aerodynamic braking. Let's just watch as he touches down out here.
No, he's waving to you. Yeah, he's waving to you.
Got another picture here looking past the...